There are 45 whale species living in Australian waters. Blue whales are one of the many whale species killed during the increase of the whaling industry. They have various mechanisms which help engineer the ocean's ecosystem. They mix nutrients when they dive and surface. They help balance food web interactions where they can influence the evolution of their prey and the ecosystem's hierarchy. Whale falls, which is where the whale's carcass falls to the ocean floor or washes ashore and feeds various organisms. And they help lower the potential of the ocean's ecosystem to retain carbon, which can become toxic to humans and animals when built up. The blue whale is the largest animal to have ever lived on Earth. They can weigh up to 190 tons or 190,000 kilograms, which is equivalent to around 40 elephants. Their size can get up to around 30 meters in length, equivalent to a basketball court, and they can live for close to 100 years. The blue whale species live in Antarctic waters and often migrate up to Australia, where they have been spotted feeding around the western and southern coasts. They are often seen in the Southern Ocean as well as the Indian and Pacific Oceans. Whaling became a competitive industry in the 18th century, and during the 19th and 20th centuries, countries like Japan, Norway, Iceland, Britain, America, and even Australia and New Zealand joined the industry. Whales were killed for things like their meat, blubber, baleen, and whalebone to make products like oil, soap, perfume, candles, corsets, and even margarine. When populations began to plummet in the 20th century, bans were put into place around the 1930s, although the killing of blue whales wasn't properly banned until 1964, around 3 decades later, with commercial whaling in Australia officially stopped in 1978. The blue whale is considered an endangered species as their population is one of the only whale populations that isn't showing signs of recovery since whaling was banned. This could be due to countries like Japan, Norway, and Iceland still illegally whaling today through the loophole of scientific research, as well as surveys of population sizes not being done since 2004, so information about the population needs to be updated. Even though a lot of work still has to be done, the Australian government has established the Australian Whale Sanctuary to protect whales and dolphins in Australian waters. And projects such as the Antarctic Blue Whale Project are being developed to survey population sizes using non-invasive techniques.